making a scarf, and I'm using the Red Heart Super Saver Jumbo, and this is in the color Macaw. This recommends a size I or a 9 hook, and it is a 4 yarn weight. It's a Red Heart size 9 for an I. And this is so pretty. I love using these variegated yarns because it's never boring and it's always changing color, and I really, really like that. So what I'm gonna be doing, where is my sample? I did a video of 3 different ways to half double crochet, and this was one of the patterns that I used in there. And I think this is gonna make a really pretty scarf. So I'm gonna make it just a little wider than this, and I am gonna run the lines horizontally. And then I'm gonna make little pom-poms on the edge. You're gonna make your chain about 180 chains long. You can make it a little bit shorter if you'd like, or a little bit longer, but that's what I'm gonna be doing with mine. So you wrap it around your neck and then let it hang over both sides evenly, and it should go to about the top of your thighs. So that will give you plenty of room to knot it or wind it around your neck. So let's go ahead and move on with the next step. Now you can use either a half double crochet or a double crochet on this, but it's, you know, your preference. I'm going to use a half double crochet. So I am going to half double crochet into the 3rd chain from the hook, but I like to go into the back bumps. You can go into the little V's or whatever you want to do. Whoops. So I am going to just go into all of the back bumps all the way across with a half double crochet. And then when I get to the end, I will show you how to do the 2nd row. And we're just gonna be doing those 2 rows alternately through the whole entire pattern. So it's a really simple pattern, very easy, and it will turn out very cute. So just half double crochet all the way across. And then when you get to the next row, you're just going to chain 1 and you're gonna turn your work, and then you're gonna go into the back loop only with a slip stitch all the way across. So just do that, and then when I get to the end, I will show you how to do row 3. Look how pretty that is. I love all the different color changes. It's very pretty. So when you get to the end of your row, don't forget to go into this chain right here. So you're just gonna do a slip stitch in the top of that chain 2. Then you chain 2, turn your work, and this is gonna be just like the first row. It's gonna be a half double crochet, and you're gonna go into these back loops only of that slip stitch row that you made, and you're just gonna go all the way across, just in the back loops only. And then when you get to the next row, you're just gonna repeat the slip stitch row. So it's gonna be every other row. So it's row 1 is the half double crochet, row 2 is a slip stitch, row 3 is a half double crochet, row 4 will be a slip stitch. So that's all you're gonna do. And then when you get it as wide as you like, then you can stop there, and then you can add the pom-pom border if you like, or you can leave it just plain. So just keep crocheting, and I will see you when I get it to the width that I want it, and we'll go from there. So here's the scarf that I did with the pom-poms. Let me show you how I did the pom-poms. So you're just going to go into the top of this chain 2 right here, just like that. You're going to add your yarn. And what I like to do is use the tail piece to secure my yarn because I feel like that works better. And then you can just pull that down and pull this and snug it up. Then what you're gonna do is you're going to chain 6. 3, 4, 5, 6. Yarn over, go into the 3rd chain from the hook with a double crochet, yarn over again and go into that same space. And you're going to yarn over and pull through two. Yarn over, go into the same space. Yarn over, pull through two. So you have three loops on your hook. And one more time, yarn over, pull through the two. One more time, yarn over, do the same exact thing. So you have five loops on your hook. And you're gonna pull through all five. Then you take out your hook and you put it into that open space right there. You're gonna pull through all of those. Then you're going to go into not the same space, but the one that's underneath that in that chain. And then you're gonna pull through and you have this little pom-pom. Then you're gonna chain three. Then you're going to go into the top of this ridge right here. You're gonna put two strands on top of your hook, pull through with a slip stitch. So now you've made one pom-pom. And on the next one, we did six on this first one, six chains. So on this next one, you're gonna do eight chains. So one, two, seven, eight. You're gonna yarn over, you're gonna go into that third chain from the hook, just like before, and you're going to double crochet. Yarn over, go into that same space, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, go into the same space, yarn over, pull through two. This is called a cluster, by the way. Yarn over, pull up that until you have four on your hook, and you just do that until you have five loops on your hook, just like that. Then you pull through all five, and you're doing kind of like a popcorn stitch. Go through this space right there, you see that? And you're gonna pull through. Then you're going to you're not gonna go into that same space where you did all of those, but you're going to go into the space below that. And just pull it through with a slip stitch. And you've made your pom-pom. Then you're gonna chain four on this one. Because what you're doing is you're making long and short pom-poms. And then you're just gonna go into that space right there with a slip stitch. See the difference? So one's long and one's short. So every other one, you're gonna go, you know, chain six, chain eight, chain six, chain eight, and then just do your little pom-poms. Let me show you quickly, again, on this next one. One, two, three, oops, four, five, six. And you're just doing them into these spaces. So you're gonna do in the middle of these spaces here and into that chain space. So that'll be one, this will be one. So you're gonna make your pom-pom just like I showed you here. And then once you're done with your pom-pom, you're gonna go into this space and slip stitch. So as you can see, that's what it looks like. So I'll show you when this is all finished. Thanks for joining me. Hope you have a great day. See you next time. Bye.